I want to look at the reaction between HBr and an alkene like the one shown here. And I want to focus not on only the products that are formed, but on the fact that we get a mixture of products. And I want to look at the relationship between those products, whether they're enantiomers or diastereomers. So we know that when we add HBr to an alkene like this, the H plus is going to add across this double bond. We're going to get the more substituted carbocation like this. And then the Br minus can add to that carbocation. And since this carbocation is planar, it can add from either the top or the bottom, giving two different products. Now I want to look at this on my three-dimensional models also. So this is my alkene right here. You can see that this alkene bond is planar. The atoms involved in the pi bond are trigonal planar, sp2 hybridized, and the hydrogen that comes in is going to add to this carbon. And that's what I'm showing here, my pi bond with my p orbitals. This is my H plus, adding to either the top face or the bottom face of this double bond. Since there's another hydrogen here already, it doesn't really matter whether it adds to the top face or the bottom face in this molecule. If this were a different group, like a methyl group instead of a hydrogen, I would get a different product depending on whether or not it added to the top or the bottom. But I don't, and what I get is this carbocation, so my hydrogen added here, and my bromine can add to either the top or the bottom of this carbocation right here. The carbocation is completely planar, and attack from either face is possible. And here are the two products that we can make in this reaction. Now I've color-coded the methyl group blue in both of these examples, so it's a little bit easier to keep track of the methyl groups here. Now, with regard to the relationship between these two products, I think we can see in these models right here that one of them is the mirror image of the other one. And I can line them up and you can see that there's a mirror plane that goes right down the middle here. And this one is the reflection of the one on the bottom. That makes them enantiomers. In fact, this top isomer is the R isomer, and this bottom isomer is the S isomer. We're not going to look at this in this video, but if there were a methyl group here, then the reaction results would be a little bit more complicated, because then I would be making two different stereocenters in this reaction, one here and one here, and then I would get a mixture of enantiomers and diastereomers. There would be four different possible products. I also want to look at one more example where I take this same molecule and I change it just a little bit so that the starting alkene already has a chiral center in it. So for instance, this molecule, pretty much the same as the first example we looked at, except I've added another methyl group right here to give me another chiral center. Reaction is going to proceed the same way, giving me a very similar carbocation. And again, the Br can attack that carbocation, giving me a mixture of these two possible products. And we can look at three-dimensional models of these two. In this case, we've got two different methyl groups. I've color-coded one of them blue and one of them sort of a lime green so we can keep track of them. And what I want you to notice is that in this case, the two molecules are not mirror images of one another. They are mirror images right here where my bromine added, but at the other center, they are not. You can see that one has the methyl group sticking up, one has it sticking out. They don't line up. There's no mirror plane through here. They're not mirror images. Stereoisomers that are not mirror images of one another are diastereomers. So these two are diastereomers. And in fact, if we assign stereochemistry for both of these molecules, one of them is RS and the other is SS. And we know that if this second one were going to be the mirror image of the first one, if the first one is RS, this would have to be SR. So these are diastereomers. Stereochemistry at this pre-existing chiral center doesn't change during the course of the reaction.